Myself is Shibsankar Das, and I'm an assistant professor in mathematics department, Institute of Science, BHU. So my topic is, today I'll be discussing only two topics. Topics name are quite, you don't be horrified with this name. I'll give some practical example, real life example, so that you can understand. These are mainly computer science. My area is theoretical computer science. I'll be discussing some theoretical computer science problem. Two standard problem are this approximate parameterized string matching problem, and the famous problem is maximum weight bipartite matching. So one of the famous problem. So these are my outline of the talk. So to start with my introduction, this introduction of this talk. So string matching is a heavily studied topic. It has lots of applications. So what it does, it finds the part of the text which is called pattern in a particular text. Generally we do lots of string searching. When, for example, if you want to find a name in a PDF, then you generally do Ctrl+F, type the name. So this is the base problem. Main problem is quite complicated. So it was the name stringology was first coined by J. Galil around 1984 in his book. Fine. So what this area does, it deals with the algorithms. What is algorithm? Algorithm is nothing but a technique, step by step techniques, so that I can, which is a solution, which is you have to perform it step by step technique to solve some problem. It solves exact pattern matching, approximate pattern matching, and searching for repetition of a pattern in a various text. These are basic things. So in which area generally we can apply this? Well, text editing program, for example, if you want to text editing program, we does it. Generally, you don't know the name, technical name, text editing program. So we want to edit something in the Word or some software. So this is the example of search engine. Lots of people do it. Computational biology, for example, searching for a pattern in a DNA sequence. DNA processing, human DNA, if you want to store the human DNA, it will take lots of space, memory space. So you need to process the DNA, for example, DNA sequence, so that it can be stored in a compact way. For example, data compression, for that we need. Okay. Signal processing, in signal speech recognition or data compression, information retrieval, if you want to get some information from a data. So these are the examples. The some of the string matching problems are exact string matching and approximate string matching, parameterized string matching, and approximate parameterized string matching, step by step. I will not go in details of the very complex definition. I will give examples so that it will be feasible to understand. Okay, so there are indexed and non-indexed version of strings matching. In indexed version, generally the name means you are allowed to do pre-processing. In non-indexed version, you cannot do pre-processing with the string. Okay, if you do pre-processing, then you can do lots of benefit. I'm not going in details. Okay, some basics of string matching. I've talked about string. What is string? So generally, strings are based on, first of all, we need to know what is alphabet. Many of us know alphabet is a non-empty finite set of symbols. For example, what are the generally alphabets? ASCII characters or English characters, A to Z, binary alphabet, and so on. Okay, DNA alphabet, ACGT generally, these are alphabets. So strings are generated over the alphabets. Okay, length of the string is denoted by mod, number of alphabet, number of letters in the string is called length of the string. Okay. So if this is an alphabet set, sigma star denotes the set of all possible strings. Okay. So here is a exact string matching versus approximate string matching with the example. I will not go in details. So here my pattern is here. What is my pattern? P is a pattern which is taken from this P is a pattern which is taken from over this alphabet, and T is a text which is based on this alphabet only. Right? Now, what is my target in exact string matching? My target is to find the exact occurrence of this pattern in this text. So, let us see where does this pattern occur. So, here is an example. So, here, so there is a occurrence of this, exact occurrence of this pattern in the text. There is another place. Another place we can have a overlap also. So, there is a overlap. Next, there is another text where we are searching not exact, some approximate occurrence of the pattern. Approximate generally, for example, we do lots of mistake as a human being while typing. While typing something, we do generally some mistakes. So, because of that, approximate came into picture. So, for example, the approximate occurrence. So, this is a, what is my pattern? A, C, T, A. My approximate occurrence of the pattern is A, A, G, T, A. So, there is one mismatch, I will say, in place of C, I have typed G. So, there is a one mismatch. Similarly, there is another approximate occurrence of the pattern. Fine. Okay. So, while I am talking about the mismatch, it is about some error model. So, there is an error model called Hamming distance error model. There are lots of error models. So, where in Hamming distance error model, what does it do? Is only you are only allowed to do only one replacement. Okay, via one replacement. Sorry, one. If you do only one replacement, this is called one Hamming distance. If you do two replacement to get back the pattern or text part of the text, you will be talking about two Hamming error model. Two Hamming distance. Under the Hamming distance error model, my mismatch is two. Okay, so these are the theoretical definition. I will not go now. Next about parameterized and approximate parameterized. So, why this idea came into picture? Around it, the idea came around 1993, is invented, given by the Benra Baker. What is the idea? Generally, idea was there was lots of software duplication. So somebody has given a software, somebody taken the software, renamed the software, recoded the software, and given. That is, for example, there is a pattern taken from this. Now, I want to find what is the parameterized version of the pattern occurred here. Fine. So under certain some mapping, this is called bijection mapping. I will not go in details. Under this mapping, the occurrence of this pattern in the occurrence of this pattern in this text is here. C A to 1, C to 2, G to 3, and T to 4. Similarly, occurrence of this pattern is here. Occurrence of this pattern is here. Altogether, occurrence of this pattern in the text is here. Then with this problem is called parameter string matching. With this, I can say that somebody have copied your text. So, in the message passing also, you can apply this thing. Fine. So, while similarly, when I am passing a message, I can do lots of mistakes. So, there is an approximate parameterized idea came into picture. So, there is an approximate occurrence of the pattern in this place and this place. So, I will not go in details. Next. What is maximum weighted bipartite matching? First of all, what we need to know what is graph. Graph is nothing but a collection of vertices and edges. Fine. Edges, of course, between the vertices. Fine. Next is bipartite graph. What is bipartite graph? Bipartite graph has two partitions in the vertices. For example, I will go to the next page. So, this is a bipartite graph. This is one partition of vertices, this is one partition of another vertices. The edges will be, of course, from this partition to this partition. There cannot be 7 minutes. There cannot be over almost. There cannot be edges between this set to this set. So, this is called bipartite matching. So, what is maximum cardinality matching? Maximum cardinality matching is, given a bipartite graph, what is matching first of all? Matching is, I have to find the subset of edges such that no two edges share a common vertex. For example, this edge and this edge does not have common vertex. But if I pick up this edge and this edge, they share a common vertex, I cannot pick up this edge. Okay? So, this is a matching example. This is a maximum matching of the graph. Maximum cardinality matching. Okay? No two edges share a common vertex. Example. Example is, you have a set of job, you want to, you know, assign the job to a certain people, you have to apply this algorithm. Okay? There are lots of regular day-to-day life we are using also. In the, there is a, you know, lots of matrimony site also use the, you have a set of boys, you have a set of girls, you want to feed, you have to feed some boys into some girls. Similarly, no single boy cannot be, as per the Hindu legal law, you cannot marry two girls. So there is an example, one of the basic examples. Okay, so weighted matching, previously the graph age has no weight of the ages. Now I have given weight for these ages. Weights denote certain characteristics depending on the certain property of the problem. So for this graph, weighted graph, we are not worried about maximum cardinality matching, we are worried about maximum weight matching. For example, for this graph, the maximum weight matching is this and this. What does that mean? I have to find a matching so that its weight is maximum. For example, this matching and this matching, where the weight is, total weight is 5, and moreover, it follows the property of the matching, no two age, these two age does not share a common vertex. Now, this is the maximum weight matching. Now, how this problem one can relate? There is a reduction technique. Is a very technical things. I will give the application. How can I convert the approximate parameter string matching problem into the graphs? The maximum graphs, there are lots of solutions are there in the graph area. So what is the target of reduction? Target of reduction is to convert this problem into here and find the solution, give the solution of this problem. Fine. So there is a last slide. So there is a given a string, this string taken from here, this string taken from here. So how can I convert these two strings into a graph and find the best matching between approximate parameterized matching between this and this? So how I have converted? So I have kept these vertices here, these vertices here. Now next phase is to draw the edges between these two vertices. How can I draw? If there is alignment between A1 and B1, so draw an edge. If there is alignment between A1 and B2, draw another edge A1 to B2. Now, next step is how to give the weight. Weight is that how many such alignment you give, that is the number. If there is alignment between A and 3 is 2 times, A3 and B3, you see there is alignment in A3 and B3, and there is alignment in A3 and B3. So I will give a weight to 2. So next, once I converted this pair of text or pattern here, then I can find the maximum weight matching. Maximum weight matching says that I under what is the maximum weight matching between these two graph, old graph only. So there is a maximum matching. If you map A1 to B4 and A3 to B3, then you can get the maximum weight. So this is the matching and weight is 5. That's it. Thank you.